The dates for the Haryana State Assembly elections have been announced. This is the first big electoral test for the BJP after its spectacular victory in the Lok Sabha elections earlier in May. This election is being dubbed as a test not just of the BJP's popularity, but also of the ability of the Congress and others to mount a spirited campaign. So, let's take a look at what the calculations of Haryana's political Hisab Kitab show. For a state that makes up only 2% of the country's total population, there are a lot of parties fighting for a slice of the Haryana cake. You have the BJP, JJP, the Congress, INLD, BSP. The list gets longer if we include Kuldeep Bishnoi's HJC and former CM Bansilal's Haryana Vikas Party, which have merged with the Congress. Firstly, why does it look like BJP versus the rest? A useful way of analyzing these political parties is by viewing BJP on one side and all parties on the other. The ruling BJP had come into power in the last elections in 2014 with 47 out of 90 seats. Om Prakash Chautala's INLD had won 19, while the Congress managed 15 seats. The violent Jat agitation in February 2016 not only exposed the sorry state of law and order in Haryana, but also damaged the social harmony of the state. It appeared then as if a strong grip on the state's law and order wasn't first-time Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar's cup of tea. But while the BJP, which won 33% of the votes in the 2014 state elections, swept all 10 Lok Sabha seats in the 2019 elections and secured a whopping 58% vote share. This certainly has propelled Khattar's chances and has projected him as the chief ministerial candidate. Amit Shah, meanwhile, has made a Mission 75 appeal in Haryana, a mission to win 75 out of 90 seats in the state assembly. The party has indeed come a long way in just a decade. Back in 2009, far from hoping to conquer 90 out of 90, the party struggled to even find candidates for all the 90 seats. Next, is the Congress divided or united in Haryana? So, how is the Congress stacking up in the state battle? As of now, it seems that they can only mount a serious challenge to the BJP only after they manage to resolve their own internal squabbles and differences. The Congress has also signalled a change in strategy by replacing Ashok Tanwar with former Union Minister Kumari Shailja as president of its Haryana unit. Former Chief Minister Bhupinder Singh Hooda represents the Jat community, and by making him as leader of Congress's legislative party, replacing Kiran Chaudhary, Congress appears to have made a soft signal of Hooda as its CM face. However, thanks to the grand old party's own internal problems, there is still some confusion among the voters about who Congress's primary CM candidate is. Is it Hooda? Is it Shailja? Or perhaps even Randeep Singh Surjewala? Finally, let's take a look at Devilal's fragmented political legacy. Om Prakash Chautala's INLD's track record in recent times has been poor. Despite strong murmurs, an alliance between Chautala's INLD and Mayawati's BSP has not materialized. While 28% of Haryana's voters belong to the Jat community, Dalits are at 19%. Together, that's nearly half of Haryana's voting population. However, that math may not work out because in recent times, the BJP has dealt a blow to this strategy of community vote banks. How? By consolidating Jats, Dalits, Brahmins, Thakurs, Yadavs, Gujjars, Baniyas, backward castes and communities under one large Hindu voter umbrella, as they did in the Lok Sabha elections as well. Add to that the abrogation of Article 370 in Kashmir and the muscular posturing against Pakistan that will dominate the electoral discourse and could even work further in BJP's favour. The only silver lining for the opposition was that in December 2018, three states in the Hindi-speaking belt, by voting the Congress to power, has sent a clear message that assembly elections are not fought or won on PM Modi's name. So, there could still be a surprise in Haryana on counting day.